In this video, we are diving deeper into ASRock Polychrome's effects, clearly displaying the effects available over multiple different connected devices so that you can have a look at each of them for yourself. Hey guys, James from TechLens here, and this video is actually additional content from the main channel video, where we critically analyze ASRock Polychrome's bugs, features, UI, absolutely everything. I'll have that main video linked in the description for you to check out if you haven't already. But there is one thing that I need to stress before we take a look at all of the effects within ASRock Polychrome. There is going to be a lot of flashing lights in this video, significantly more than usual. So if you're at all adversely affected, if you're harmed by this, if you develop seizures, anything like that, please consider not watching this video because I can't have you injured from watching a YouTube video. That's stupid. So now that we've covered the most important thing, which is your safety, let's take a look at the effects within ASRock Polychrome. So as we mentioned before, we are using ASRock Polychrome version 2.0.89. So as a recap of the lighting, we have a splitter going two ways. One way to this addressable RGB strip, and also to all of the fans, starting at this rear one, then daisy chained all the way down to the front bottom. And the reason for that is so that you can see the effect in both an RGB strip and also daisy chained fans, as they will display the effect in slightly different ways, but it will be the exact same effect sent to both of them simultaneously. We also have a second addressable RGB header being split two ways, one way going to the G-Skill pump block, and also to the accent lighting running along the top and also the rear side of the case. And then lastly, we have a non-addressable RGB header being split two ways, one way going to this RGB strip so that you can see how the effect is being displayed, and also by the side of the radiator, which is probably where I would actually put it in a build. And then the graphics card and the memory are going to be their own devices, controlled through ASRock Polychrome, right here. So this is the main screen that you're greeted with when you launch the application. So let me show you the effects inside ASRock Polychrome. So at the moment, we have select all channels for the motherboard. So this is going to control the I/O cover, the PCH, the RGB strip 1, RGB strip 2, addressable RGB strip 1, and addressable RGB strip 2. By selecting all channels, we control them all at the same time. So if we click on mode, this then gives us access to all of the effects that we can use within ASRock Polychrome. So starting with off, a great effect, I love that effect. But other than off mode, you have 14 different effects that you can choose from in this section, with the first being static. Of course, you can select the color here. I actually really quite like this color picker and color wheel. Plus, you can also increase and decrease the RGB values independently right here. And within Polychrome, if you have access to changing colors, you have about 100 different stops on this slider. And that's the same with the opacity. There's about 100 different stops in there. So moving on from static, you have breathing, which is basically exactly what you would expect it to be. And you'll see that when we clicked from static to breathing, we now have access to speed control. And if you're using an effect that has access to speed control, like the opacity and color, you can change that in 100 different levels, which is kind of crazy. So this is breathing at its lowest point, which is incredibly slow. And then breathing like that, which is almost a strobe. So speaking of strobe, that's, wow, too much. There we go. Strobe is a weird effect. Let me know in the comments if you use strobe. I don't think anybody does. So moving on from strobe, for which you have color, opacity control, and speed, we have cycling. Now this is a strobe of R, G, and B. And if you increase the red will be brighter when it comes to it. Or decrease the red will be less bright coming to it. And I'll show you that with green. And again, opacity control, you can do that for everything. And of course you have speed here down the bottom. Next up we have random, for which you don't get color control, but you do get speed control. Now this will blast a random connected device a random color. So next up we have music control. And what that will do is if we play a song, let's move that over here, bounce that over to there. It should then produce a lighting effect in time with the music. So let's see how that works. 3, 2, 1. I don't think that's too bad. It kind of looks a bit messy, and it's weird that it's only pink and blue, because if we go back into this, we don't have custom color control, which I think is quite odd why you wouldn't have custom color control within this effect. But in all fairness, compared to Gigabyte RGB Fusion 2.0, that is a much better implementation of it because it's not lagging behind the music by several seconds. Next up, we have wave, which seems to be a non-addressable RGB color wave. As in, the addressable RGB strips are just every LED the same color. Speed control, no color control. Next up, we have spring. Now, Spring seems to flash non-addressable RGB strips just randomly, like that. It's like a double flash. But you'll see for the addressable RGB strips, it's bouncing to and from the connected devices. So it's going all the way down the path and then all the way back. We can change the color, of course, and we also have speed control. There we go, if you wanted to go a little bit crazy. Next up, we have Stack. Oh, wow, okay, no, we need to turn that down. So Stack seems to be very similar to Spring, but instead of bouncing back down the strip or the connected devices, it lights up the last LED that is non-lit. So you can see in the fans that it's appending an LED essentially to the end. With the non-addressable strips, it seems to just spaz out, apparently. That's the best way that I could describe that. And then when it fills up the stack, as in all of the fans and this RGB strip at the bottom, once they're all illuminated, it will then reset. Also, bear in mind that because this RGB strip and the fans are using a splitter, the LEDs have been set up in the software to be the maximum amount for the fans, which far exceeds that strip. So when the fans get to about the 24th LED from the end, this would start illuminating and stacking as well. That's not an error with the software or the fans, that's just because I'm using a splitter. Next up, we have CRAM, which of course is color controlled and speed control. And the best way to describe this is kind of the opposite of what stack is. It's just adding LEDs till it gets all the way to the end and resets. Now you'll see what I mentioned about stack right here. You'll see as this LED strip zeroes out and then goes all the way to the end. And once that is full, the effect continues on for the rest of these RGB fans. So next up we have scan. We get full color control and also speed control. And what that seems to be doing is a small amount of illumination on everything and then sending a few LEDs down the connected devices to then reset at the end. Next up we have neon, which is your favorite carnival, of course. If we go full red, you know, I see some people liking that, but that definitely is not for me. Next up we have water, which looks exactly the same as neon until you look a little bit closer. You'll see around the RGB fans, there's less LEDs that are being illuminated at any given moment. But then you'll also notice we don't have access to color control. But what that's doing is rainbow cycling at the same time. It does seem to be slower natively, but of course you can just increase the speed and then it would be as fast as neon. And then finally, rainbow, which is a rainbow that I really like. I like when companies think about how the implementation is going to look as an end result. You'll see that colors are almost chasing one another and they're fading out and it looks a lot more beautiful than LEDs sequentially just changing colors down a connected device. There's something a lot more mesmerizing when it comes to rainbow effects that are well implemented in color chasing. I really like this design. So now that I've shown you the main 14 effects, there's a reason why we haven't linked the graphics card or the RAM. Let me show you what happens when you do. You'll see that immediately music, wave, scan, cram, stack, spring, and water all just got grayed out. You cannot use them when you link memory or a graphics card. Now this is probably to do with ASRock not implementing these effects on stuff like memory that is not ASRock memory. I don't think they even make memory. But they can't guarantee that these effects will look the same or display correctly on, say, every memory module that they support. So the chances are that's why they've grayed them out. So what we have remaining here is what I would call global lighting effects, as in you choose one of them and it lights up the entire system, every connected device, including the memory and the graphics card at the same time. You'd think that you get all of the controls that you did previously. And although that's true for color on, say, like strobe, cycling, you don't get color as before. Breathing, you do get color as before. You'll notice that you don't get speed control anymore. To do that, you'd have to unlink the graphics card and the DRAM, and then you'll get speed control back. But the easy way around that is going into the graphics card. Now, we're going to give them the benefit of the doubt here. This is a 6600 XT, not an RX 590. It is a brand new card. It's basically a week old. And although I can't guarantee that you'll get all of these effects with every compatible graphics card, you do get nearly all of the ones that were in the main section. The only one that is missing is music, but you do get rainbow right there and rainbow 2. The difference between Rainbow and Rainbow 2 is that Rainbow 2 is more of a normal color cycle, very sequential, whereas Rainbow 1 is as previously. It's more of a color chasing, which I do prefer. And then lastly, taking a look at the memory, we have a drop-down list of 13 different effects, with a lot of them being completely different from what you saw previously. But again, it is worth mentioning that these effects may not be the same effects for every memory module that's compatible with Polychrome. So what we'll do is we'll change this over to static. We'll just give that a white and change that to like mid to low, just so that you can see the effect on the memory modules. You can turn it off at any point with this toggle. Here we go. So rainbow, as you see here, it's a rainbow going upwards. Unfortunately, you can't change the direction, which I think is very much a missed opportunity. So we'll start from the beginning. Here we've got static, and then we've got color controls. And of course, color control is also brightness control, as in that's most of the way bright. This will be all the way off. There we go. So breathing, let's change that to a blue. Unfortunately for the memory, you don't get to control speed with any of these effects, which I think is a bit of a shame. So if we go onto flashing, for some reason that just changed it to red, which is a bit of a bug, but not the end of the world. Then we have color cycle, which is a non-addressable RGB color cycle. And then if we change it over to rainbow, we do get the addressable RGB color wave. It just seems weird that it's going up instead of down, and there's no way to change that. I mean, I would prefer it going down. I think it just looks better, but that's my opinion. So if we change it over to breathing rainbow, you can see that as it fades in and out, it also changes color. Now, it is worth mentioning that there seems to be some sort of randomization in the breathing timing between the modules. So if we fast forward a little bit, you can see right here that they're all lighting up at very much different stages. And from my experience talking to people, you'll either love that or you'll hate it. I personally actually really like it. Next up, we have Comet, which is an LED shooting up followed by a trail of lighter LEDs. Rainbow Comet is changing color as it does the Comet effect. Moving Flash is very similar to Comet, but you don't have the trail of LEDs behind the main one. Moving Flash Rainbow, I'm sure you know what that would be. As you can see here, it changes color whilst doing so. The wave effect waves across the memory modules while slowly changing colors. Now, as far as I remember, this is one of two effects that is actually top to bottom, which is kind of odd, like why? It seems weird. Anyway, the other one that is glowing yo-yo, which I'm not even sure how I'd describe that. It's a bullet LED, colorful, changing colors, sent down and then chased by a fast wave. Honestly, I actually quite like this effect. And then last but not least is Starry Night, which I guess could best be described as twinkling stars, whilst also color cycling. Quite a nice effect. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you found this video interesting and or informative. If you haven't checked out the main channel TechLens and the ASRock full video analysis, I'll have them both linked in the video description for you. Otherwise, like, subscribe, all of that good stuff, and I'll see you in the next one.